Hello everybody, hello dear students. I hope you are fit and fine and healthy. I have wear mask to protect myself from coronavirus. As you know that it is a thing that protects ourselves or family members, so it is a must. We should wear it compulsory. And as you can see here, we are here together for the subject English grammar. It is of standard 6th. Myself, Mahesh Talukda, I am going to teach a topic, sentences, phrases and clauses. Now before starting the topic, let me just give a brief information about the importance of grammar. As you know that grammar, yani ki vyakaran, wo koi bhi bhasha mein kafi important hota hai. Wo chahe English ho, Gujarati ho, ya Hindi ya Sanskrit, koi bhi bhasha ho. Vyakaran kafi important hota hai. Let me just give you a simple example to make you understand that what is the importance of grammar in learning any of the languages. As we know that for speaking, for reading, writing or listening the correct sentences or for getting the meaning, grammar is one of the most essential thing. It is the main foundation of any language. In other simple words, let me just give you a brief example so that you can understand. As a small child, we love to play games, isn't it? Yes, we like to play games. And what if our friends are cheating? They are not following rules and regulations? Yes, definitely we would not play with them. In the same way, grammar is as important as the rules and regulations in game, because it provides rules and regulations for speaking, listening, reading and writing. So it is the most important thing. And today's topic, that is sentences, phrases and clauses, which is the most basic thing and which will give you a great amount of knowledge that you can understand a sentence, a phrase and a clause means. You can read, write, speak and listen properly. So let us start. As you can see, sentences, phrases and clauses. Sentences we are learning from first standard, that I'm happy, I'm sad, all that sentences, phrases and clauses that we'll discuss today in detail. First of all, about a sentence. Let me just give you a definition of sentence. A sentence is a group of words that gives us complete sense, and it has subject and predicate. It starts with capital letter, it ends with, generally ends with full stop in affirmative sentences. For asking questions we use question mark, for showing certain feeling we use an exclamatory mark. So it is a sentence. Let me just write here so that you can understand. First, sentence is a group of words, as I told you earlier, which gives us complete sense. Sense, another word I can use, that complete meaning or a thought of a speaker. Then, as I told you, that it has its own subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. You might have known about this. If you have not heard or if you do not know about these two words, don't worry, I'll explain. And as I told, that a sentence starts with a capital letter. Generally, in affirmative sentences, ends with full stop. Then it ends with a question mark and an exclamatory mark. Generally, for asking simple questions, we use question mark. For showing certain feeling, we use an exclamatory mark. That is our sentence. And subject and predicate, I'll make you understand in one simple example. Let me write an example so that you can come to know about this. Here I wrote a sentence that Ram plays cricket in the morning every day. Here, as you can see, first letter it is capital. Sentence ends with a full stop, and the first word of the sentence, it is a noun, name of a boy, that is known as subject. And the other words which are given in the sentence, plays cricket in the morning every day, are considered as predicate. Ram, a boy, as I told, what activity he does? He plays cricket when? In the morning, and this activity is being done every day. So we have a full meaning of a person or a complete sense. That is why it is known as a sentence. For other examples, I can say that as we have studied sentences from the first standard, that I am happy, I am sad, I like to play cricket, I watch TV, Sita cooks food every day. Those are the examples of sentences. You can try yourself also. So I hope it will be clear in your mind what is a sentence and examples also. Let us see. The second topic, that is phrases. A phrase, again, like a sentence, it is also a group of words. In sentences, it gives us full meaning or complete sense, but here it gives us some sense. And third important thing, it does not have its own subject and predicate. Now let us see one or two examples today, so that you can clearly come to know the difference between a sentence and a phrase. Example, we can give that every now and then in anger next week, next year, next month. Many examples we can give about phrases. Here you can see that in anger means somebody is very angry, but about what, about which person or about whom he is angry or she is angry, that we do not know. That is why it is a phrase, because it gives us only some sense, not the complete sense. You cannot see any noun or pronoun in this red colored sentence, words, a group of words. There is no noun or verb, so it does not have its subject and predicate. That in simple sense, that we can identify as a clause. Let us move towards the third topic. I hope it is clear with you. Third topic, it is clause. Like sentence and a phrase, it is also a group of words. It is considered as a part of a sentence. Generally, it is a part of a larger sentence, but we can say that it has its own subject and predicate. Generally, it is connected with another clause. So here you can say about clause, that it is a group of words, it is a part of a sentence, then it has its own subject and predicate connected with another clause. And let us give examples so that you can understand. Rahul said that he would visit the zoo. Here I have written a sentence which consists more than one clause, but generally Rahul said it is a part of a sentence that he would visit the zoo. The underlying words are known as clause because it has subject, it shows verbs also, and other words are known as predicate, and it gives us some sense that he would visit the zoo. But who said that, we do not understand. That is why it is a clause. In phrase, only little bit information is given. In clause, it is more compared to phrase. One thing I would like to tell you, that sentence is made up of clause. So sentence contains phrases and clause both, but these two cannot form a sentence. Clauses, in some of the clause, it is also a simple sentence. For example, he plays cricket regularly. It is an example of clause. It has its subject, it ends with a full stop, but then also it is a clause. Clauses are generally of two types: independent clause, dependent clause. Independent also there are three types, but that you will learn in further standards. So I hope these three things are clear in your mind. Now let us check if you have got complete information about these three. Can you identify yourself about phrase, clause or sentences? I'll write few sentences, I'll underline few words, and you need to identify that if it is a phrase, if it is a clause or if it is a sentence. So let us write the sentences. First, at 8 p.m. sharp, at 8 p.m. sharp, the gong sounded. Here I'll underline first three words, that is at 8 p.m. sharp. So let us see that if you can identify or not. Here at 8 p.m. sharp, it is a group of words. Does it give a complete sense? No, it does not give a complete sense. It does not have its own subject or predicate. You can say noun or pronoun. It is missing from here. So it is an example of phrase. Let us see another sentence. This is the house that belongs to my brother. This is the house that belongs to my brother. Here I'll underline the words that belongs to my brother. Let us see if you can identify or not. Here you can see it is a group of words. Does it give a complete sense? That belongs to my brother. But what? It is impossible to guess without these words. This is the house. So it does not give a complete sense. But if you see, it has subject and predicate. So it falls in the category of a clause. I have written C for clause and P for phrases. Let us see the third sentence. stop that noise. Here you can see that I have underlined all three words and. Can you identify if it is a phrase, clause or a sentence? Yes, that is right. It is a sentence because it starts with a capital letter, it ends with a full stop. And when we read, stop that noise. Someone is getting harassed by unwanted sound. So that is why it said that stop that noise. We have a clear sense what it tries to speak. So it is an example of a sentence. So I hope that you have understood about sentences, phrases and clauses. Thank you very much.